Soundings presents an unabridged recording of The Girl from Vichy, written by Andie Newton, read by Lucy Scott. The moral right of the author has been asserted. This performance is owned by Soundings. Historical note. On a warm June day in 1940, inside a train car deep in the Compiègne forest, France signed an armistice with the Third Reich, something no other invaded country had asked for. Under the armistice's terms, France was split in half, one part occupied militarily by the Germans, the other free, where France's leader, Philippe Pétain, and his newly formed Vichy regime had unfettered control. To the French people, Pétain promised a separate state of peace, but to Germany, he promised collaboration. 1942. Chapter 1. Vichy, France. I stopped running just under the large clock that hung above Gare de Vichy's stone archway, my heels skidding on the cobblestone ground. I had seen the clock hundreds, maybe even thousands of times before, having lived near Vichy my entire life. But this was the first time I heard it ticking and saw its pointed metal hands actually moving. Across the street behind a curbside flower cart was my sister, Charlotte, watering a blooming fuchsia hanging from a hook outside her maternity boutique. A feeling hand swept over her pregnant belly, and I tugged my berry down low. Squeezing my pocketbook, I could all but feel the letter inside, addressed to the Sisters of Notre Dame de la Compassion, asking them to take me in. They'd never know Mama was the one who wrote the note, forging it in Papa's best handwriting just moments ago in her kitchen.